Hi everyone, in this lecture we are going to discuss about the saving crystal system. This topic is very important for any competitive point of view in the chemistry. Okay, now first, without any trick we cannot remember this topic, I think. Okay, so we have to remember the saving crystal system. Saving crystal system is consist of cubic crystal system, second one is a tetragonal crystal system, third one is orthorhombic crystal system, fourth one is monoclinic crystal system, fifth one is triclinic system, hexagonal system and rhombohedral system. Okay, now in the exam point of view, we have to remember here the axial length and interfacial angle of for this saving crystal system. This is a very important topic. Okay, so here you can remember here easily the trick, cute our mother. Okay, here Q for cubic, T for tetragonal crystal system, O is for orthorhombic crystal system, M is for monoclinic crystal system, T is for triclinic crystal system, H is for hexagonal crystal system and R is for rhombohedral crystal system. Okay, first we have to see first is the cubic crystal system. In the cubic crystal system, all the axial lengths are equal. That is, A is equal to B and B is equal to C. Okay. But in the tetragonal system, here two equal signs, here one equal sign and here zero equal sign. Okay. Here also zero equal sign, here zero equal sign, here one, there is one equal sign and here there are two equal signs. Okay. Means what? Here, from cubic to cubic to orthorhombic system, the equal axial length is a, means symmetric system is a decreases. Okay, and here suppose you can remember here in this three crystal system, that is a orthorhombic, monoclinic and triclinic system, A is not equal to B and B is not equal to C. Okay, you can remember here these three system are most asymmetric system or asymmetric system, because there is a unequal sign will be there, that is a unequal sign. Okay, and here now you can remember this, and here now we have to see the interfacial angles. Here in these three crystal system, that is a cubic, tetragonal and orthorhombic, alpha, in this three crystal system, there is alpha interfacial angle are equal. That is, alpha is equal to beta and beta is equal to gamma and gamma is equal to 90 degree in this three crystal system. Now, in the fourth one system, that is alpha is equal to gamma is equal to 90 degree. Okay, means what? Remember, remaining term is a beta. That is, beta cannot equal to the 90 degree. Okay. Then here you can remember that in the triclinic system, we have to remember here tri means what? There are three unequal sign. Okay, means alpha is not equal to beta and beta is not equal to gamma and gamma is not equal to 90 degree. Here there are three unequal sign. So this is the most asymmetric system due to the unequal sign. Okay, and here you can remember easily by comparing the monoclinic and hexagonal system. Okay, that is, in the monoclinic system, there is a first alpha and gamma are equal to 90 degree. Okay, and remaining term is not equal to 90 degree. That is a beta term. Remaining term is a beta. But here, the remaining term is a 90 degree. That is a gamma. Okay, so gamma is not equal to 90 degree. Means what? Gamma is equal to 120 degree. And also here the alpha is equal to beta is equal to 90 degree. Okay, by comparing these two crystal system, that is a monoclinic and hexagonal, these are the two opposite system. Okay, and here you can remember that the alpha is in the rhombohedral system, the alpha is equal to beta, beta is equal to gamma and gamma is not equal to 90 degree. Okay, means what? This system is opposite to this system, this three system. Okay, I think it is clear for you. When we go from here to here. And here, suppose these two systems are equal in axial length. Axial length, that is a cubic and rhombohedral system, axial length is equal. And in the tetragonal and hexagonal system, the axial length is equal. In the rhombo, orthorhombic and triclinic system, the axial length is equal. That is, A is not equal to B and B is not equal to C in this both system. And remaining term, the monoclinic system, the A is not equal to B and B is not equal to C. So, with the help of this, you can remember that. In the previous exam, the question is asked from a which is the most symmetric system. Okay, first we have to see in the symmetric system. What are the symmetric system here? First one, here A is equal to B is equal to C, and here also the A is equal to B is equal to C. Means what? Due to the equal sign, these two systems, equal signs or due to the equal axial lengths, these two systems are equal, means symmetric system. Okay, but in this system, the interfacial angles also equal. So this is the most symmetric system. That is a cubic system. Cubic crystal system is the most symmetric system. And here in the rhombohedral system, the A is equal to B is equal to C. But, means what? Here axial length is equal. But the interfacial angles are different. That's why it is a not that much. Means this is the less symmetric system. Rhombohedral system is the less symmetric system. And remaining all systems are the asymmetric system. Due to their different axial lengths. Okay, but here most asymmetric system is triclinic system, because in the triclinic system you have to remember that the tri for three different interfacial angles. Okay, that is alpha is not equal to beta, and beta also not equal to gamma, and gamma is not alpha, beta and gamma is not equal to 90 degree. Okay, I think it is clear for you. Thank you.